Hi, I'm vocal coach Eli Prinsen from hybridvocaltechnique.com. Today's video, I thought I'd do a little something different. Instead of analyze a vocal track, I'm kind of going to analyze it, but I thought I'd give you a little insight on how to actually sing the song, okay? So this is kind of on the fly. I haven't heard this song in a long time, but we're going to kind of piece this together, and I'll give you a little bit of hybrid vocal technique theory as I do this to give you a little taste of how we do things. Okay, so this is a song by Rainbow when Joe Lynn Turner was singing with them, and this is called Street of Dreams. Okay, so let's check some of this out. Let's see what's going on here. Okay, so first parties, I heard the sound of voices in the night, spellbound, there was someone calling. So it's not too terribly high yet. So about F sharp on the highest point there. There was someone calling. Now, for some low voice people, and I remember when I was learning how to sing, I say that he's not too terribly high there yet at F sharp, excuse me. But I remember when that was very, very high. So let's talk about that real quick, and we'll get right back into the song before we get into the much more difficult areas. Okay, so it is the approach. It is how you approach these notes. If you can get yourself to feel like this is matter of fact, or convince yourself this is the lower part of the song, which it is in this case, you can keep yourself from engaging a tremendous amount of anxiety and muscular tension before you even vocalize anything, okay? So one of the techniques that we use a lot in HVT, which I learned from my master voice teacher, was the use of a mirror, okay? So my teacher used to make fun of me a lot when we would do different exercises, but he'd say, Eli, watch the mirror, make the adjustments. And he'd say, he would stop me before I would even sing a line before. He'd be like, wait. And I'd be like, I'm just about to sing something. And I'd be like, whoa, I'm thinking, what the heck's going on? And he says, I got you. He goes, you didn't even sing a word yet, and you've already stopped and clamped yourself up. You're behind the eight ball. You game over, and you haven't even sang the first word. And I'm like, what are you talking about? And he says, watch the mirror. He's like, right before that first, for instance, if it was this song, Street of Dreams, and the first word, I heard the sound of voices in the night, right? I would have been like, I heard the, with the tensions coming in before the voice. So then he would say, Eli, is the range of the song too high for you, or are you just, you know, are you making it harder than it actually is? And I'd be like, wow, never thought about that. So I started paying attention to that thing, to the mirror, for all different reasons. I did a lot of different weird stuff. So I would think about it. I heard the sound of voices in the night, spellbound. All right, so I've already got some stuff going on vocally, some vocal training techniques that I'm already using, even though this is the lower part of this song. But pay attention to the onset of your singing, to right before you sing, with the use of a mirror. The mirror is awesome for fixing and training, for vocal training. You can see things that you can't feel. So if you have a teacher like me, and there's some other teachers that like to employ the use of the lift, right? Ah, to lift up the soft palate and make sure your tongue's down and give you an open throat and all that. A lot of us will teach that. Well, you'd be surprised how many people think they're doing something and they're not doing it until they look in the mirror, and then they'll either catch themselves not doing it or catch themselves doing something that's completely crazy, like I used to do. Or they'll be like, oh, wow, I'm not doing it, and, you know, start doing it. So I'll tell most of my students, you know, it's like a grin. Smile, all right? And then that will allow some of that buzz to go up there automatically. It's just like a bonus. You feel like you're cheating to get your placement because it's so easy, all right? So on this first line, I'm breathing through my nose. Ah, and I think the sound up in here. I heard the sound of voices in the night. All right, well, I got a couple of little things going on already. And I'm not singing super high here, but I'm tuning some of the vowels, not only to modify them and open up the vocal track, but I'm also modifying things for placement. I'm finding these special pockets for my voice to go into. Okay, it's called tipping. All right, so I'm doing it, and I'll give you a little example. Even in the lower range, I heard the sound of voices in the night. Right here, spellbound. All right, instead of spellbound and splatting eh, spell, I actually put a little bit of eh in there. Spell, spell. So it's like a mixture of eh and eh. All right, check it out. Now you'll hear it plain as day. I heard the sound of voices in the night, spellbound. There was someone calling. I did the same thing on someone. There was someone calling. Okay? Instead of, there was someone! And it being trapped down in my throat, which all the SLS community will say, oh, see, pulling chest. You can't belt. I've been in my chest register the whole time. Okay? And I'll remain there for this entire song. This is a song that I would belt if I wanted to sound like Joe Lynn Turner, okay? Now, obviously, if I was a very, very low bass, I might bridge and mix to hit the C sharp 5 at the end, okay? But I'm not. I'm a kind of a middle-high baritone, all right? There was someone calling. I looked around. No one was inside. Pulled down and I kept on falling. All right, pulled down. I did the same trick. Pulled down. Now the word is down, right? If I do it literally, pulled down. Okay, I can get the sound. It's not too far out of my range where it's not doable, but it's more difficult on me. I feel like the sound is thicker and I can't get it up where I want it. Okay, so I modify not only for the vocal track, but for placement. And that makes your life easier as a singer. Okay, let's continue with this song. Let's check out a little bit more. I've seen this place before, and you were standing by my side. I've seen your face before tonight. Okay, did you hear what he was doing just from the things that I said a few minutes ago? Okay, so he starts singing a little bit higher. Okay, so he's up here around A4. All right, and Joe Lynn Turner's voice is fantastic. Okay, one of my favorites. Okay, so he says, and I'll use the mirror so I can watch and monitor some of my technique here. I've seen this place before, and you were standing by my side. Okay, so we're up here at the A on place. So if he would have splatted that out, right? I've seen this place! We would have got that. We'd have got a lot of cracking and yelling, a lot of width. The sound would have been thick, and it would not have tapered and tipped up into the mask where I need it to go in order for a baritone to attempt to sing a rainbow song, okay? Let's continue. Let's check out some more. Maybe I just see what I want it to be. I know it's a mystery. Do you remember me? On the street of dreams, running through my mind. Okay. So. Okay. So he's right in there in the money notes. And the money notes, by the way, in my opinion, have always been either from middle C to high C or F to high C. It's where a lot of popular choruses are. And we're actually probably the most difficult areas for the male voice on the middle side of that, and then the upper side of that for the females for most of the bridge areas or transition areas, mix areas, okay? But this is all belt. This is all belt. So this is all M1 chest voice belting, okay? So we got the typical area where everybody struggles. We got F sharp, G sharp, and A4. And the vowels, do you, so we got ooh, which is pretty unfavorable all over the world, which is fascinating to me because that is the end of the vowel mod chain for ah, for the modification chain to get the throat open. But everybody will struggle singing oohs. They clamp the throat down depending on which vowel they're coming from, okay? So I got a couple of hybrid vocal technique tips, tricks, and techniques that my students already know about. Okay, so ooh, do you remember me? Okay, so you have the two most universally hated vowels, ooh and e, for high belting. Okay, it's usually the ones, you know, I've heard coaches I really respect, the old coaches saying e is a killer. And they would have their own way of modifying it, and I have my way too. Okay, so do you remember me? Right there. Do you remember me? Okay. Do you So I was doing a couple of little modifications in there. On ooh, if I would have stayed very throaty on that and dampened, do you? I'd have never made it up there. If you think of an ooh vowel as staying dark and in the throat, you're never going to get up into the mask. You're never going to get the voice to tip and get that strain out of there. Okay? So right away, you got to get the voice up in here. Do, 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 do. I like to imagine a virtual eye in the spelling. I do a lot of visualization. HVT, there are so many techniques that go into hybrid vocal technique. It'll blow your mind if you've never studied it. A lot of it are visualizations and brain tricks. We will actually think of a word being spelled a different way to get a different feeling when we sing it. Okay, and that's exactly what I'm doing right here. So on Do You Remember Me, just to give you a little piece of this, I'm putting, instead of D-O in the spelling, D-I-O. Now, I know that spells D-O, but think about it. If Mountain Dew were spelled D-O-O, Mountain Dew would be all down in your throat. Okay, then you think of it as D-E-W, Mountain Dew. Now, what if it was Mountain, and it was nasty, Mountain Dew, ew. Okay, so now a dark ooh is ooh, ooh, ooh. And then you slightly tune it to get away from the squeeze. Do, do, do. And now the ooh vowel is placed and tuned up in the mask where it should be and not stuck and horizontal and fat in your throat, making you ooh get stuck. Okay? So then what happens? We modify vowels, but then And in training, how many times has this happened to you? And forgive me for doing this. I hate in-ear monitors. They're stuck and it's driving me nuts. We train to modify vowels in the vocal training room. But then we go to sing songs. The words change. Okay. But from word to word, even within one word, the vowels change. Excuse me. And so we have to modify them and find ways to get from one to the next. Right? Because everything is, wouldn't it be wonderful if you could sing the entire song on mum? Mum, 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 mum. Like you might do, well, you'd probably do that in head voice if you're studying SLS. But we can't. We have consonants and all the vowels change, okay? So you got to remember all your consonant or your vowel mods, but you also have to remember and find ways to make them flow from one to another and find a favorable placement so that you can sing the tough songs, okay? So I used the little trick, ooh, ooh, to get the ooh to be easier in a higher belt. Now we're going to the E. E is a killer, right? Do you remember me? Okay. Do you remember me? Okay. Well, I modify my E's a little different than some people. Okay. Some people will modify their E's to A or E. Well, it's no longer an E. If you're going to splat the song because that's the way someone covers it, then sing your E's like an A. Okay. In hypervocal technique, we can do that way or we can go to I. What makes it an E is shaping it as an E. E, smile, say cheese, cheese, E, there's your E, okay? But I am coming off of do you remember, I'm gonna use I. Do, remember it's nasty, ooh. Do you remember me? So E, I'm shaping E and I'm singing I. That's keeping everything up in the mask, okay? Allowing a baritone to belt up to A4. Let's continue. Let's listen to some more. Okay, you can totally hear him doing this. You can totally hear him using these same techniques. Okay, I hear him, send him myself, I know you set me free. He's using a lot of eh in the sound, a lot. Okay, listen to this little part again. Okay, listen, let me back it up a little bit. So good, like we never parted. Okay, now he's using a modification right there. Some things come over me. He's using, check this out. Listen, this is vowel mods in use here. Check it out. Right back where we started. Some things come over me, and I don't know what to feel. Maybe this fantasy is real. Now I'm gonna see what I want it to be. All right, what if he'd have sang it like this? Now I'm gonna see what I want it to be. Then it's gonna sound a little more like Don Dokken, right? But his sound has a little more in there. Check it out. Now I'm gonna see. Did you hear all that? Are you listening for these vowel mods the way I am? Probably not because I'm an obsessed vocal coach, but listen to this. Don't know what you feel. Something's come over me, and I don't know what you feel. Maybe this fantasy is real. right? But it's still a mystery. Those E's have eh, right? There's a lot of going on in there. Joe Lynn Turner's amazing. But it's still a mystery. And right there, running through my memory. He has a little bit of going on behind there. Running through my memory. It's all open. This is keeping his throat open, keeping it from collapsing. Check it out. Okay, so we're on that part. Okay, right in there we have, when he sings this, now back it up and you'll hear it. Now I'm going to speak it an octave lower, but he says, on the street of, and then dream. All right, now if I'm deadpan doing this, you're going to hear how I'm going to do this an octave lower and speak it to where you can really hear what I'm talking about when I talk about how vowels are modified. On the street of dreams. Okay, on the street of dreams. Okay, all of a sudden that lift that me and a lot of these other coaches, the ones that I think are good, okay, on the street of dreams. The vowel mods start to disappear once this is lifted up, okay? Now, let's listen to this high part again. Did you hear it that time? Did you hear it? On the street of dreams! He had on the, and then on street, there was it in there. On the street! Right? And then right way up here at B. So he had on the street of, and then dreams. On the street of dreams! And that's how he would bring that big old voice way up there and sound so thick and awesome. Check it out again. Oh, I see what I want it to be. Okay, so he's kind of doing, there's a little mic technique going on. He's kind of backing off, you know, because that's very, very, very high to belt at C sharp 5, you know, C sharp above 10 or high C, right? But he makes it up there because he is not only modifying the vowel, but he's doing a split modification to get the resonance to live up where the head voice lives, even though he's belting, okay? On the street of dreams, running through my memory. On the street of dreams. Okay. All right. Now that one was what? That was mixed voice. Don't tell anybody. Okay. So you do have options. You have options for singing that. Now, belting it is going to sound more legit if you're trying to sound like Joe Lynn Turner when you sing this, okay? Now, if your voice is very, very, very deep, you may not have a choice but to use that mixed voice like I opted out and did just now, okay? But when you study with hybrid vocal technique, you have choices available to you because I teach everything. Anyway, let's listen to a tiny bit more and then we'll move on. Okay, so right there, we have, it's almost like the guy studied with me. It's crazy, even though he's better than me, but he's using a lot of the emotional stuff that I teach. A lot of like the sobbing in the mask and some of the belt and sob and lift up into the chest dominant mix, you know. Do you notice what it means? So you go up through the palate, up through the mix, up in there with that sobbing in the mask. You know, there's a lot going on there. On the street of dreams! A lot of different ways to get into that part of the voice. Okay? Anyway, I think I made my point here. There's a lot of vowel modification going on there. A lot of the way you approach things that will make them much easier for you to sing. It's not all about screaming and straining from your throat. There's places to push from. There are things to release. There are things to thin and tip out and place and modify. A lot of different things that go into singing great big difficult songs where the belt is concerned. But anyway, if you need help, if you are interested in this stuff, you've loved this stuff as much as I do, hit me up at hybridvocaltechnique.com. I teach on Skype or Zoom private lessons. Have home study programs, several of them at hybridvocaltechnique.com, and also HVT VIP membership where you get all of the vocal training programs, including my teacher's programs, the legacy content, and also live streams and giveaways and all kinds of fun stuff. All right, so I hope you come and check out Hybrid Vocal Technique for yourself and enjoy training and singing whatever the heck you end up wanting to sing after your voice is trained. All right, take care. See ya.